In this video, we will go over the following sections. First, we will create AdBS Lambda using Terraform. It will be a simple Node.js function without any dependencies. Also, I'll show you how to automatically redeploy the function if you change the source code. Then we will create API gateway using Terraform and integrate it with Lambda. To invoke a function, we will add HTTP get and post methods. Finally, we will create another Lambda with external dependencies, as well as we will grant additional permissions to access S3 bucket and read a file. You can find the source code and all the commands I run in the video on my website and GitHub repository. First of all, let's create a Lambda function. I will use Node.js runtime for the first example, but the steps are almost identical for all languages, except that you need to manage dependencies slightly differently. For Node.js, we use npm and package.json file. For Python, it would be requirements.txt and so forth. We will start with a simple function without any dependencies. Give it a name for the file, function.js or maybe index.js, it does not matter, it's just your personal preference. As always, this function accepts the event object. For the debugging, we can print out the event. You can find it in the CloudWatch. If this function is invoked without any payload or query, it will return hello world. We will integrate this function with AdBS API gateway. If you invoke this function with URL query, for example, name equal to Anton, this function will return hello and then the value from the query parameter. We can optionally also check for HTTP get method. For the second if statement, let's check if the HTTP method is post and get the name from the JSON payload. Then pretty standard response. Specify the status code 200, content type and the message to return to the caller. That's all for this function. As I said, it's pretty simple. Next is Terraform code. First of all, we need to declare version constraints for different providers and Terraform CLI itself, as well as we need to declare AdBS provider and specify AdBS region where we're going to create S3 buckets and Lambda functions. When you create AdBS Lambda without Terraform, you can use zip archive, Docker images, or even write code directly in AdBS console. With Terraform, we typically use zip archives. The workflow is the following. We build a function with all dependencies, package it as a zip archive and upload it to S3 bucket. Then when we create Lambda, we point to the zip archive object in the S3 bucket. Since S3 bucket names must be unique, we can use random path generator to append it to the bucket name. Then let's create S3 bucket itself with generated name. You can also block all public access to this bucket, which is my default setting. The following file will contain the Lambda Terraform code. As with most of the AdBS managed services, Lambda would require access to other AdBS services, such as CloudWatch to write logs. Or in the following example, we will grant access to the S3 bucket to read a file. We need to create IAM role and allow Lambdas to use it. Then we can take this role and attach a bunch of policies. As a bare minimum, we would need a standard AdBS Lambda basic execution role. The next Terraform resource is to create Lambda function. Give it a name, for example, hello. Then specify the bucket name where we would store all the Lambdas and the key pointing to the zip archive with the function. For runtime, let's choose Node.js and handler should match your file name function. Source code hash needed to redeploy the function if you change anything in the source code. For example, update the business logic. If the hash of the zip archive is different, it will force to redeploy Lambda. The final argument is IAM role that we just created. To debug, we would need to create CloudWatch log group to store all the console.log statements and errors in the function. I usually set retention to 14 days. You may choose to keep it for a month, which will also affect the cost of running Lambda. Then the controversial data resource that packages Lambda as a zip archive. It's controversial because it has side effects. It produces a file. For local development and testing, it's okay, but for production, you should build CI/CD pipeline that can handle this without using that resource. The last component is to get this zip archive and upload it to S3 bucket. Ideally, this would be part of the CI/CD pipeline as well. ETAG triggers updates when the value changes. Also, if the object is larger than 16 megabytes, this may not work. For the following function with dependencies, we will use another method. We're ready to initialize Terraform and apply it. When Terraform completes its steps, you should be able to find a newly created S3 bucket with a random path generator to hold Lambda functions. Hello.zip contains our function. Also, we have AWS Lambda Hello CloudWatch logroup. And the Lambda function itself is packaged as a zip. Since we don't have API gateway just yet, let's invoke this function with AWS Lambda invoke command. Specify the region and a function name and a random file name to record the response of the function. If you print the response, you should see the message "Hello world." Now let's go over a quick exercise. Let's update the source code of the function and check if this will trigger redeployment. Rerun the Terraform apply. Now you should see two changes in the S3 object and Lambda, since the hash has changed. Let's invoke it again. You can see the change that we have made. The next step is to create API gateway using Terraform and integrate it with our Lambda. We're going to be using API gateway version 2 API. For protocol, you can use either WebSocket or HTTP. For this tutorial, I will limit configuration to name and protocol type only. You can find all the possible options in the Terraform resource documentation. Next, we need to create API gateway stage. One of the ways to think about stages as different environments, such as dev, staging, or production. Some people use it to version their APIs. Let's call our stage dev and enable auto-deploy. Then, totally optional, you can enable access logs. You can specify what attributes you want to collect and store in CloudWatch, such as source IP address of the client. To store logs, we would need to create CloudWatch logroup and define retention. In the next Terraform file, we will integrate API gateway with hello Lambda. First of all, you need to point to the API gateway ID that we just created. Then use hello Lambda IRN. For Lambda, you also need to use AWS proxy and post request to forward requests from API gateway to Lambda. We can specify what type of requests we can pass to Lambda. In the first example, we use HTTP GET method and hello endpoint. For the second, let's use POST instead and the same hello endpoint. In both examples, you need to specify a target to be our Lambda. We also need to grant permissions to the API gateway to invoke our Lambda function. Finally, let's print to the console the URL that we can use to invoke the Lambda. Go back to the terminal and apply Terraform. That would be the base URL for the API gateway. It would have a single dev stage. Under the routes, you will find POST and GET methods. Let's test HTTP GET method first, append the hello endpoint, and optionally provide the URL parameter. The function should parse it and return the message hello and then the name from the URL parameter. Also, let's test the POST method. In this case, we provide a payload as a JSON object to the same hello endpoint. It works as well. Now you can find the access logs in the CloudWatch. The first GET request and the second with POST. In the final section of this video, let's create another Lambda function with external dependencies. Also, let's grant access to this function to read a file in a new S3 bucket. We can create a new test S3 bucket using Terraform as well. Use the same random path generator and for prefix test. Then create this bucket and disable public access. We can also create object in that S3 bucket using Terraform and JSON code built-in Terraform function. It will convert the name equal to S3 to a valid JSON object and save it in a newly created test bucket. Then we configure our new Lambda to access this bucket, read the file and return it to the caller. Output variable with a bucket name. Now let's create a new AWS Lambda function in a new S3 folder. We need to import AWS SDK, then initialize the S3 JavaScript object. Let's get the bucket name and object from the payload. Then simply use try catch block and return the content of the object. We also need to initialize this Node.js project. It will generate package.json files with dependencies. You can fill out this. I'm going to skip all of them. Then install AWS SDK node module. That's all with the function. Now we need to create Lambda with Terraform. You can create a new IAM role for Lambda, then attach the same basic execution role. To access new S3 bucket, we need to create another IAM policy and allow get object from our bucket. You also need to attach this policy to the S3 Lambda role. Similar Lambda function resource. Give it a different name, for example S3, and the same bucket to pull the zip archive of the function. Here we attach a new policy with S3 bucket access. Let's create another CloudWatch log group for this function. Zip the function and upload this zip to S3. The difference for this function is that we need to install all the dependencies before we can apply Terraform. If you have CI/CD pipeline, you would have separate steps to build, test, and upload the zip. If you just want to deploy it from your local machine, you can create a simple wrapper around Terraform. This would be extremely simple script, just to give you idea of how to build and deploy it. First, you need to install all the node modules, preferably with npm CI. That will use package log file. Then you can run Terraform. Let's make this script executable. Finally, let's run it. Alright, we have a bucket. We can invoke this new S3 function and provide a JSON payload with a bucket name and the object. It worked. Lambda was able to get object from the bucket. In case you need to make a change and redeploy, it's also simple. Rerun the same wrapper script and test it with invoke command. It works. I would suggest creating a CI/CD pipeline that can build your functions and automatically redeploy them instead of running Terraform from your local machine. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.